Bag. In this video, we are going to solve example 3.4 that is taken from chapter number 3, Mechanical Properties of Materials, and book name is Mechanics of Material by RC Hibbeler, and it's 9th edition. So statement is a bar made of A36 steel has dimension shown in the figure. If axial force P is equal to 80 kN is applied to the bar, determine the change in its length and change in the dimension of its cross section after applying the load. The material behave elastically. So you can see this is the bar, clear, and its length is 1.5 in the direction of Z. Its width is 100 millimeter and thickness is 50 millimeter. So this is the cross section. This is the dimension of this cross section, and P load is applied in the direction of Z. So you have to determine the change in length in the direction of change in the length in Z direction. Also, you can see due to this load, this thickness will reduce and this width will also reduce. So you have to determine the change in length in direction of Y axis, as well as change in this width in the direction of x-axis. So let's start with the solution. So what will be the first step is that you can see this P is equal to 80 kN is applied over this cross section. So so area will be equal to, this is rectangular, so this width multiplied by thickness will give you area. So 100 millimeter in meter is 0.1 meter and thickness is 50 millimeter, which is 0.05 meter, and it will give you square meter. Clear? Now we will first find the normal stress. Normal stress is equal to sigma, which will be in the direction of Z. So therefore I am writing sigma Z is equal to P divided by cross-sectional area. So P is 80 kN. So 80 into 10 raised to the power 3 Newton divided by this area, which is 0.1 multiplied by 0.05 square meter. And when you solve this, you will get sigma Z will be equal to 16 into 10 raised to the power 6 Pascal. Now we have this stress. Now we know that also this sigma Z is equal to epsilon Z multiplied by modulus of elasticity of this material, which is A36 steel. So we do not have this E value. So how we will get this E value? So you can get it by using this book. So at the end of this book, you can go to the property tables and you can see the average mechanical properties. Now you have this table. From this table, you can check it, A36 steel. So its E value is 200 gigapascal, and we will also take the Poisson ratio value, which is nu. So this nu will be equal to 0.32. So I will write it over here that from average mechanical properties table, we get E of steel is 200 gigapascal, and Poisson ratio, which is represented as nu, and that nu was 0.32. Okay, so you have this E value. So using this equation, you can see that strain in Z direction is equal to sigma Z divided by E of steel. So you can have both the values. E is sigma Z is 16 into 10 raised to the power 6 Pascal, and E is 200 gigapascal. So 200 into 10 raised to the power 9 Pascal. So when you calculate it, you will get strain in Z direction comes out to be 80 into 10 raised to the power minus 6. Either it will be dimensionless, or you can see millimeter per meter or meter per meter. So this is the value of strain in the z direction or in the direction of the length. Now what we will find, we will find the first change in length, which is original length is 1.5. So change in the length in z direction, we know that strain sigma z is equal to change in length in z direction divided by original length z. Clear? So from here, this change in length in z directions comes out to be epsilon z multiplied by original length, which is lz. So sigma z, epsilon z is 80 into 10 raised to the power minus 6 multiplied by, this is length in z direction. So I can write it, this is 1.5, so I can multiply it with 1.5 meter. So when you solve this, you will get change in length in z direction comes out to be 120 into 10 raised to the power minus 6 meter, or delta z comes out to be 120 micrometer. So this is the change in length of this bar. Now what we will do is that we will move toward finding the change in length in x direction and change in length in z direction. As I have told you that due to this load P, there will be increase in length in z direction, but this will cause decrease in this thickness and decrease in this width. So that can be obtained by using another formula, and we know that this Poisson ratio is equal to minus strain in lateral direction divided by strain in longitudinal direction. So again, I will show you that the strain in z direction is longitudinal strain, and strain in the lateral, that is perpendicular to this longitudinal, either in y direction or in x direction, will be the lateral strain. So from here we can write that we are going to find out this longitudinal, this lateral strain. So we can see that this lateral strain will be equal to minus nu times longitudinal strain, which is, now longitudinal strain, which we have found out, this longitudinal strain is equal to epsilon z, and this lateral strains are epsilon x and epsilon y. Epsilon x and epsilon y, and both are equal. So we can write this, that this epsilon x is equal to epsilon y is equal to minus nu time epsilon z. So you have both the value. Epsilon is taken from this table, which is 0.32. So minus 0.32 multiplied by epsilon z is this one, which is 80 into 10 raised to the power minus 6. Okay. So when you solve this, you will get value will be minus 25 into 10 raised to the power minus 6, and the unit will be a meter per meter. Clear? And that will be minus 25.6 micrometer per meter. This is epsilon x and is equal to epsilon y, strain in lateral direction. Now for finding changes in the dimension of cross section, or we know that this epsilon x is equal to change in direction of x divided by original length of this x. So this change in length of x will be equal to epsilon x into lx. Epsilon x is minus 25.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 6 multiplied by lx. So length in LX direction is this one. This is LX, which is 100 millimeter. Or this is 100 millimeter is equal to 0.1 meter. So I can write 0.1 meter. Okay. So when you solve this, you will find the change in length in X direction of the cross section, which comes out to be minus 25, minus 2.56 micrometer. Similarly, you can also find this change in length in Y direction is equal to strain in Y direction is equal to change in length in Y direction divided by original length of Y. So we can find this change in length in Y direction is equal to epsilon Y into length of Y. So epsilon Y is minus 25.6 into 10 to the power minus 6, and Ly, length in Y direction. This is Y direction. So this length is equal to Ly, 50 millimeter. So 50 millimeter is 0.05 meter. So when you solve this, you will get this change in length comes out to be minus 1.28 micrometer. So these are the answers of our these questions. Okay, so this is the change in length in X direction, and these are the change in length of the cross-sectional dimension that is shown. And that was all about this problem, example 3.4. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it, and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.